Radha Krishna Pranamur, you remember? You can do. अतिमिरांदस्य ज्ञानंजन शलाकय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतिशे गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदालयै कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो भक्त्याभिहीनापराधलक्ष्यै क्षिप्ताश्च कामादितरंगमध्ये कृपामयीं त्वां शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणा We have explained in Srimad Bhagavatam the Dhruva Upakhya, how hard a story it is. He did giving up any kind of food, water, even air, everything he gave. Now you should think that what we have given up. No? So you should make a comparison. And you can see that in how much water you are.
In how much water you are. Hot water.
How much?
Level deep, how deep?
How deep you are.
How deep you are.
We are in one.
Thinking.
That what we have. He came, he left his home penniless. No? Nothing with him. Only there was some door coping. Alone came. He came in at the bank of Yamuna and thinking, I must do or die, I will have to take darshan of Hari because my mother has told. So I will do or die, but my object of my life is this, to have a darshan quickly and to be emperor of whole world. Thus, only for emperor he do it. And what we want, our object is so high, so we will have to pay so much high, more than what he did. As a result, he got the emperor of whole world, he became. But he, after that 36,000 years, bogus things I have taken. Bogus. When I will go giving all these things to other planet, I cannot take my even a hair. Nothing. So why I am doing all these things? Nonsense. So he was repenting. So what should we do? What is this real world? What is this? Then Sukadeva Goswami began to tell the life of Devahuti and Kapil Sambhad. You know, there was a rishi, his name was Kardam Rishi. And also Manu, that is Prajapati Manu, has a very beautiful daughter, so qualified and beautiful. At that time he was most beautiful in whole world, and so qualified. Kardam Rishi is like a Shaktavesh avatar. Shaktavesh, you think, understand?
Empowered.
Or it can be told that he was manifestation of Godhead. He was so learned and he has so many kinds of yoga siddhi.
Yoga
siddhi means?
Mystic perfection.
He wanted to be in a renounced order and to do bhajan. But Brahma was upset. He was thinking that all my sons and grandsons are being like Narad, in the line of Narad. How this world will be cultivated? So he went to that Kardam. And requested that you should not be, you should follow me. If you go to jungle, what will be there? Why not being in household life and chanting and remembering, doing all these things, and also making santan, sons and daughters and
children.
Try to obey me. And he told him and requested him to be a householder. And then Brahma himself arranged his marriage with
Devahuti.
They were married. Both were young, and by his yoga vidya, he at once called a very good Biman's airplane. If he wished this Biman, this airplane becomes smaller, and when he wanted so bigger, and like a very good palace having all the
facilities
there, everything.
Air condition.
And then air condition or anything more than heaven also. Worldly this, now a bicarpenter, everything is going on. So more than this, and in the being in that
airplane,
they used to go to in the very beautiful valleys, like Kashmir Valley, Alps Valley, oh beautiful, anything in world, Niagara Jalprapat.
Niagara waterfalls.
Waterfalls, here and there. And they touring in the whole world, in beautifulest places, and testing worldly desires. And after that, Kapil Dev came in her home. He is also told Gyanavatar.
Saktavesh
avatar of knowledge.
Import incarnation of knowledge.
And gradually he became young. When he became in the age of 16, his father Kardam told his wife, "Now I want your permission to go in dense forest and to meditate Krishna." And he told what is world, and you should also engage yourself in this. And I have left my son, he is so
qualified
in tattva gyan and everything, treat him like a Bhagavan. And he quickly left that place. Then one day Devahuti called his son, and there was a dialogue, very beautiful dialogue, that how a soul comes in this body and how he gives up. What are his requirements, and never it fulfills, coming and lakhs yonis.
Species.
Sometimes fish, eggs, hens,
tortoise,
and then the Western peoples, especially Muslims, when you have any child, a little, they will cut like this and give masala so much.
Spices.
And they will go like this. Fishes, sometimes donkey, sometimes pig and hogs, sometimes demigods in heaven, sometimes like Himalay mountain, and your life will be like Himalay, lakhs and lakhs. Crores of years of life. So There is in the last birth, how he will remember, he will be like that. That kind of body he will have. How this body comes, this soul comes out in the last, through nose, eyes, this ear, mouth, and
genital,
anus,
two
doors,
rectum,
any of these, there are nine
gates,
any of them. If the soul, at the time of you see that a person is dead and his eyes are opened, then you should see that it has come out from
eyes
and it will go in the rays of sun and it will go in the sky and there clouds are there. He will be covered with clouds, waters, and again it will come down. If it is has gone by this, then with air he will go. No? If by
rectum.
Lowers,
rectum and genital.
If it has, then it will go to
hell.
Narak, hell.
See you.
And he helped to test so many things there. If a man is lusty, at once they will arrange a very red iron pillar and forcibly they will tighten it in that. Oh, you should test all lusty persons like this. If you have done any wrong thing, always hinsa,
violence,
cutting animals and doing all these things. Yeah? Then there are so many dogs there. There are so many tigers and all these things. At once they will attack you and you take attacking everything. And after that you will not die, but and there is a very big
pan. Fire pan,
river, frying pan. And their oil is
boiling,
going
hot.
Tuck buck, you know?
Boiling hot.
Coming. Flames are coming and they will give it to you.
Yet you will not die.
But you will not die. Only you will taste
all
the sufferings. But if any is pious one, he had not done so much bad activities, very little. And he has done some good activities, pious, serving father, mother, obeying them, not doing any, not hinsa, violence and all these things. Then it may be that it will be phat jayega. फटना का क्या?
Skull will crack.
Crack
हो जाएगा. Crack. And from here, आत्मा will go.
Busting होती
है. And then, there are two marks for them. Archimarga. From so many black, andhakar.
Darkness.
He will have to go. Where? He will have to go gracefully, even from Bhur, Bhuva, Swaha, Maha, Janat, Sata. And from there they will go to Mohini Lok. Eight
covers.
Anywhere he will may go. And those who are more pious, they will go to heaven for some days and again they will come. And after that, again they will come covered with water's layer, through clouds, and they will come down. If they are in jungle, the root of the trees will take that water. If any human being is taking that water or taking fruits, that seed is there. Tree will take water and it will go to fruits gradually. And those who will take fruit, it will come here. And it will be, after some days, the maila, it will come like a stool and urine, and the seed will be there, it will grow into, transferred into blood, and thus from blood coming, then virja,
semen,
and again woman and men, otherwise in animal or anywhere, in trees, male and female, thus again coming in the womb. After death, how it comes? Like this. Leaving one body, but first entering in another body. Any womb or anywhere. First, he is here, but he will go there. Then, he will take himself from there. If a man is dying, his soul will go first there, anywhere. And they are going, and then he will leave this place.
That if a person is dying, and he is yet not dying, first he will go to that womb where he will take birth.
He will die, but something like cyclic order, it will be seem that it is going on. If you will ride on a cycle and do like this, and then don't do like that, but so many yards it will go away. So many. But we are not doing anything again to do it. Similarly, Atma is there. If he will give at once, even some symptoms will be seen that he is not dying. But he has left.
He has left
already. The action is. And then he will enter there and then give up. No? Sometimes it becomes that he has so much desire and attraction to the family or anyone. No? So he will not go there. He will be in the air. And being there, circulating here and there. And when their shraddha is done, shraddha, you know, then he will give up. Then here. There are so many rules and regulations. Like in court, if anyone has done anything, you have murdered anyone. The punishment of murder is that sentence, usko bhi mrityu dand hoga.
You should be hanged also to death.
This is common, but it may be that he will not be hanged. They will see that what was your intention to murder or not. If two boys were playing with pistols and there was no
intention
to murder, and in playing they
by chance
and anyone was dead, he will not put to
sentence.
There are not only these thousands of sections for all these things. So in this also there are so many sections doing all these things nonsense. But in the last, anyhow, a devotee came pure and he told in your ears at the time of death, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama. He will have not to go here and there. Oh, very quickly. Or he will come in the shape of a pure devotee. And practicing, he will go up. So, Kapildevi is telling, Jyanne arvindakshi vimuktamani nastvai jastabhavat abhisuddha buddhaya arujya krishnena parampadam tato patanti anadrita jushmadhanya. Even a yogi who has controlled his senses and he is always thinking that aham brahmasmi, aham brahmasmi, aham brahmasmi, soham, soham. But not he has honored Krishna in his life. Then, being so high, and he will again to return in this world. And those who have done nothing, but in the last, Al-Jajamil, only he has kept his son's name, Narayan. He was so bad person, left his father, mother, wives and children, and went to a prostitute. 8 sons were there. Last son was kept name Narayan. And when he was dying, he was calling his son, but he was saved from death. Not only he saw the 4 Vishnu door. And at once, they quickly defeated Jamadurt, and he was saved. And then he was chanting, Narayan, Narayan, Narayan. And when he became pure, again that 4 doors came and took away. He has nothing to taste all these things. He is telling that if by chance, anyone, any soul in the womb of mother, how his first month he will be like a very little seed covered with water sharir, airy sharir and others.
5 elements.
And then covered with stool, urine and so many things here. In a deep ocean of stool and so much
nasty.
Nasty, so much
smell.
Durgandha.
Foul smell.
Foul smell.
If anyone will leave his wind through
passing air.
Air, and you can see how beautiful, marvelous fragrance is coming. You cannot sit here. No? And there, here. So he's tightened. After some time, it becomes vigor. After 6 months, something, all
limbs
are coming out very little, little, little. About in 6 months, all limbs are there, little, little. Head, eyes, everything. But covered, like cow's cough when coming, covered, like covered. And he's tightened so much. And this head, where?
Down.
And he's tightened so, like this. So much. He cannot move his hands and everything. You cannot imagine now, but you have imagined in the womb of your mothers. Sometimes mother used to take very hot coffee, tea,
chili.
So many medicines, very, very poisonous. And touching the boy, very sukumal, soft,
tender.
And crying there. But he cannot do. He cannot take breath. because he is in stool and all these things. More than stool, rotten things are. Then he prays in 8 months or 7 months. He prays, "Oh Krishna, if he is fortunate and he had done something pious thing, he had chanted and remembered Krishna in his past lives. Oh Krishna, save me, I am dying. I cannot hear all these things. Take me out of Om. I am promising that when I will come off the womb of my mother, I am promising that I will surely
serve you.
Chant and remember. Save me." Sometimes it may be that if he is so fortunate, Krishna may give his darshan. Bhaktivinoda Thakur and all acharyas have written like this, but not so many, very rare. But promising
in the womb.
But anyhow, Krishna, if after 9 months he is so happy, merciful, he comes out of. How he comes, you may know. Suffering so much, now you are happy, you are smiling, you are doing, and at that time, he cannot speak anything. So much suffering there. And first this comes, sometimes he become like this here, and doctors are called and to operate, and then sometimes he died in Om, and anyhow he comes. But when his sister's mother, Nevaras, taking, pacifying him, and all like this, harassing, and doing like this, then weeping. After some time, he forgets all this. After that, when he becomes of at the age of 5, he is given to school to learn something. Up to young age, and after that he becomes expert in anything. And father always and mother always worry how to give marriage, and he should again have any child. Then he is married, and he is now doing something to make money to support him, his wife and children, so many cows. Gita Sansar you saw yesterday, and hundreds of childs quarreling themselves here and there. And I have nothing to say more. Kapil Dev is telling that you can think yourself, realize yourself. And about the age of 50, you should renounce, otherwise again you will be old. No one will care for you. Your sons, daughter and grandfather will tell, why this old person is not dying? They will take by hook and crook everything what you have collected in your life. Oh father, oh mother, and they will take. And in the old age, you will have nothing a pious, nothing a for than penniless. And then you cannot walk, you cannot
speak,
talk, any doing nothing. And a very beautiful, not beautiful, Kaluti, very black, very dangerous,
ugly.
Woman will come and will try to marry you, and that is oldness. Okay. And very possibly it
will marry you.
Certainly. And then a gang of so many rogues,
diseases,
They want to be
attack. Victim. Everything will come and attack at once. And then they will take your body in burning ghat, or it will be given in
burial ground.
And then your body's body, money, you will become like insect there.
Swarm.
Or shigar.
Jekyll.
And crows will take all these places. Or it will be burned to ashes. But soul were again like this. So he is telling. So, Devoti, and in the last Devoti, praying that you are God yourself. Please be merciful to me. She left everything, his home and everything. He became mad in Krishna prema, always chanting Krishna, Krishna, Krishna like this. He even forgot to wear cloth to cover. When she is doing a stool or passing urine, he also forgets.
Devotee.
Yes. Couple dev after that he left the place. Unnaish. Kahan gaya, bhul gaya wo. Devotee couple sambar. कौन मध्य आछे चतुर्थ
ये देखो देखो
देख छोड़ तैंतीस तैंतीस शब्द है तैंतीस तो तीन उनतीस तीस चौंतीस जन्नामधेय म्रियमाण मानो जन्नामधेय श्रवणात् कीर्तनात् यत्प्रहणवाद् स्मरणादपि क्वचित् स्वदोऽपि शब्दः श्रवणाय कल्पते कुतः पुनस्ते भगवन्नु दर्शनात् अहो वत् सपचोप अतिगरियान् यज्जिवाग्रे वर्तते तु नाम तुभ्यं ते पुस्तपस्ते जुजुषसनुराज्या ब्रह्मानुचरूणां गीत गृह्णन्ति जेति शी इज प्रेइंग टू कपिल दैट Even a person always eating the flesh of dogs or sugar, pigs and all these things. But he hears and chanting name of Krishna. He will be at once liberated. But Brahmins, doing so much tapasya, heard austerities. Tepus tapaste juju shashnu rajya brahmanu chun gridanti yeti. Those who are not chanting and remembering the name of Krishna, they will have to go, what I have told. Unlimited chain of birth and death. Suffering and sorrow. This is realized truth. That is why you are not believing and not doing so much chanting name and so weaker. But if you will faith on these things, then you must chant. You must always remember, meditate what they have told. So we should have so much faith in Krishna Nam. Anyone chanting name, hearing name, glorifying Krishna, his pastimes, his hearing, anything he is doing, then he will be at once liberated. And those who are not doing, then will have to come again and again. So be merciful to me, she is telling. I want to serve you. And saying this, Kapildev went in chanting and remember Krishna anywhere, and she left his home at once, and she became mad, telling Krishna, 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 nothing. Perhaps someone can see that she became mad, not bad. Evam pratasva priyanama kritya jata anurago de chitta uccai hasat tatho rodati rauti gayat unmadayat nityat lokavahi. Dancing, remembering, sometimes so laughing when Krishna comes. And sometimes he feeling separation. Oh Krishna, where to do? And rolling down on the earth. So much weeping. Anyone cannot calculate all these things. And very soon she left this world, this body, and his soul was totally purified, and she went in Vaikuntha. So Parikshit Maharaj told that you should follow. Otherwise you will have to go in the womb and again. Then?
So in between, Kardam Rishi, her husband and she remained in home and associated with Kapil and came to this position. And Kardam Rishi went to jungle. Out of both, who were the superior position?
Both. Because they were incarnation of God. He was so high, and she was also became so high. Then also, there was a king, Parikshit Maharaj is questioning and he is answering. How we are unsatisfied in this world, moving here and there. We are so beautiful, but we want that more beautiful things. To enjoy all these things. Where is wo?
Prem Prayajan.
Prem, nahi.
Purukam Prabhu.
Purukam Prabhu? Where he is?
Purukam Prabhu?
He will be absent. You told him?
Yeah.
And that is why he has not come. He is hearing. Who can tell? This Puranjan Upakhyan?
Lalit Mohan.
Lalit Mohan? Where is Lalit Mohan? He is built. Oh, come on. Come on. Give me a mic.
Yeah, you can
stand. Please feel free.
You should always think that it is true to anything.
Full extent.
If you are not chanting, remembering, doing Bhagavad Bhakti, then you will have to test like all these things. Anyone cannot save. What about Puranjan Upakhyan? You should tell it in brief.
Gurudev surprised me as usual. He asked me to speak about Puranjan in Malaysia, so that's the last time I actually studied this Upakhyan. And as I was going to tell this Upakhyan, I said the story of Puranjan And Gurudev corrected me. He said this is called an upakyan. A story gives the meaning of something.
In this world, anyone is not satisfied with their stage. So, here.
From where Gurudev left off, just here, Puranjan was a king, and he was traveling throughout the world looking for a residence, which we all are doing, actually a place that we could call home to reside. He traveled all around the earth, and he couldn't find a place that was satisfying to him. He finally went over the Himalayas and came into a beautiful land, the land of India, and he saw so many beautiful streams and valleys, and he thought to himself, yes.
But before this, he has done so much very hard austerities. Like he was doing so much fire sacrifices that everywhere in world there was Kush.
He did these sacrifices to find a place in the world and to have happiness in this world. And this is what many people think Vedas have within them, is that the means to attain happiness within this world. Not understanding that the Vedas are slowly leading us to the goal of understanding that we're something beyond the body. Puranjan Maharaj, not understanding these things, was looking for a residence within this world, and he was very, very lucky to actually go to India. So as he was traveling through these beautiful gardens, it was as if this place had been prearranged for him. He had come through all these other areas of the world and seen. Hadn't seen sculpted gardens and beautifully arranged rivers and things like that. But in this place, he actually saw those things. So as he was walking through the gardens, enjoying the beauty of nature, he saw a very beautiful woman coming toward down the path. And she was very arresting for his eyes, and he became attracted to her. She was surrounded by many maidservants. And maids, and also she was guarded by a very powerful snake, and he became charmed and in wonder. Here's a beautiful woman by herself, walking through the forest. Anything can happen to her. She's just surrounded by other women, so she's in danger. So the king approached this woman and said, "What's your name? Where do you come from? Who are your servants? Who is it? What is this snake?" And he asked her all these questions. And it says in Srimad Bhagavatam that it's very, very pathetic when a strong king or a figure like this actually addresses a woman in this way, because they should be self-satisfied. It shows already that they're being entrapped. So as he started asking these questions, he was amazed because this woman did not know where she came from. She didn't know who she was. She says that these are my servants. I don't know where they have come, but they are serving me, and the snake has always been with me, and I don't understand my position. So the king was also, he was commenting, he was saying, "You're so beautiful." Flattering the woman, and so they became attracted to one another. And they were married.
No. What? After what? The. Here, who are you? Why you are roaming here and alone? What is your name? What you are you doing? What you are searching? Then what she told?
I thought she was saying that I don't know who I am.
No.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
So. So what happened was, she said, life is about enjoying. It's about being satisfied in this world. It's about maintaining one's level of happiness. She said, there are sages here in this land of India who will try to convince you that there is something beyond this world, that there is an absolute world where one can enjoy, and one should control one's senses. One should undergo austerities and penances to achieve this higher world, to achieve this higher love. But she's saying, these sages don't understand the truth. She's saying they don't understand what it is to enjoy. They don't understand what it is to have a home, to be a man and a woman, to have.
She told, I am a lovely princess.
I am such a bridegroom.
And I am so beautiful. I want to marry anyone. A person beautiful like me. And that is why I am searching. They are my sakhis. So, I am so fortunate to see you, that you are so young. You are like a king, prince, so beautiful, having all qualities. So now, I want to be with you. They can become so happy that what I wanted, this is
coming.
Doing prastav,
proposal.
Oh. And see, also they agreed and they were married. Then after that,
they built a wonderful city to live in. A city that had with walls, with 9 gates to the city. A beautifully arranged city with
so many gardens,
streams.
And there was a big, very big palace having all kinds of
facilities.
And 9 doors. Go on.
And the king was actually very much enchanted by his new kingdom and his new bride. And he lived for a long, long time there, enjoying. And he had many children with the queen. And it said that he had friends. And with these different friends, he would actually leave through the certain gates. Sometimes with one friend, he would leave through the north gate. And with other friends, he may leave through the south gate. And when he went with these particular friends through a particular gate, he would go to a certain destination. As he lived his life, he didn't understand that at every moment his life was being stolen from him by time. That he was as walking, like when a person is walking through the forest, he didn't understand that there was an archer with an arrow pointing at his heart, and there was a ferocious tiger waiting to devour him. The tiger being death, and the archer being time, taking away at every moment our lives, just like we live every day, and without doing bhajan, without being with Vaishnavas, we're actually, time is stealing something so precious to us, which is that which we can use to serve Krishna. He didn't know any of these things. He was completely enwrapped in his own life of satisfaction. So he told his wife, he said, today I'm going to go out and I'm going to go hunting because I'm a king and I must do these things. So he got in his chariot and he left the kingdom, and he went out and he killed so many animals. He murdered lions, and he murdered tigers, he murdered elephants, he murdered antelopes, gazelles, squirrels, everything. And because thinking that I am a king, this is my dharma, I am a fighter, so I must practice the art of fighting. And when he got back to his kingdom, he couldn't find his wife. He was wondering where she was. So they said, oh, we've seen her in her room. She's very depressed. She's on the ground. She's crying. She's sulking. So he went and he found her, and he picked her up and he tried to console her. And he was very much a henpecked husband, and always trying to satisfy her desires. And what happened was, as they were living life and having children and celebrating in their village, the village was attacked. It was attacked by a horde
enemies.
Thank you. Enemies and
Gandharvas.
Thank you. Gandharvas, and also by a black race and a white race. So the city was being ransacked and destroyed, and it was all of the princess's guardians and maidservants were being killed, and the snake was trying its best to protect the village, to protect the beautiful kingdom. But even the snake was losing its life force, its vital energy, by being constantly hammered by weapons of the opposite party. So ultimately, what happened was the city was completely crushed, and the snake had to leave the city, for fear of becoming completely destroyed, it had to leave everything. It had to leave the woman, it had to leave Puranjan, and it's left the city. What Narad Muni is actually explaining this story. This story is a metaphor for our lives. Puranjan actually means that spirit dwelling in all of us that travels.
Jeev, conditioned soul.
That conditioned soul within all of us that travels from body to body. I've often thought, and to see if all of us could think about the lives that we have lived in the past, that would open up like a deep chasm below us, and we could see all of the things that we once were. We would take life a lot more seriously. And this is what Puranjan represents, is that within this story, Narad Muni is delivering this to King
Puranjan.
Prachinibari. And he's trying to convince the king that the king should leave and actually undergo austerities and try to understand the supreme truth. And this is where Gurudev was saying that it was this king Prachinavarsha, who was undergoing so many fire sacrifices and yajnas and Vedic ceremonies in order to increase his happiness and his life in this world. So this is the story that Narad Muni...
No, more explain. What is his palace?
Right.
What is...
Nine gates. Snake.
What is that lady, woman? Who is that lady? And how he was attacked? What are all these things?
When he saw...
You should sit.
Very good.
Puranjan himself, like a soul, conditioned soul, not chanting, remembering, always he wants to taste this world, beauty and lust and all, drinking wine and killing animals and doing all nonsense that nowadays people are doing. He was not satisfied with his kingdom and his wife and his children. So he was searching very beautiful, more women to taste. In the forest, Buddhimani intelligence was that woman. Intelligence. And the house which he selected, nine doors and lakhs windows. What?
Four.
And nine doors means?
Two, one, two.
So these are nine doors. In upper doors, he used to come through eyes and to see beautiful sceneries. By sound, he wanted to taste beautiful, sweet things. By tongue, by mouth, he used to
taste
so many things, tastes. And by tongue, he used to quarrel and doing chattering, pattering, all these things. So all doors were there, and what was a snake with five heads?
Five hoods.
Panchapran. Apan, Bayan, Udan.
Pran, Apan, Bayan, Saman, Udan.
Like, without anything, if you give here, air will come and it will take easily there. There is also when you are going to pass stool and urine, where you were?
You are
filling seat?
No. You gave me an assignment to read the story of Puranjana.
Puranjana, and it has been told?
I was trying to read it, but it is very long.
Very long. Now it is seven, more than seven. Class is going to be over. Then easily it comes down, urine and by the help of air. And breathing this, this is pradhan.
Prominent.
Prominent vayu, pran vayu.
Life air.
So all these are like life, but these are not life. Soul is another thing. So the intelligence over this worldly wants to taste whole world. What? Rupa, rasa, gandha, sabda, sparsha.
Sense objects.
What?
The sense objects. Five objects of the senses.
Sense. But never satisfied till last breathing. Never, never. And after some times, there is one friend always taking care of and good advice is giving. Who is he? Himself, Paramatma. And soul is he. Sakshi, that is Paramatma here. Always giving instruction. You should not do this. Oh, you should chant, remember. You should have a good association. But he never cares for that. And after an old lady came. Who is he?
Old age.
Old age. And forcibly he married. And then he attacked with his whole armies with jar. Jar means?
Disease.
Or
fever.
Kashi. Cough.
Fever.
Cholera. Plague. Idleness. So many things. And defeats the king. And ruins the kingdom. And thus he becomes helpless in the old days. And he tries to be saved by these. But at once Jamdut comes, come and they take it forcibly. After that, he was thinking of his wife. Because always he was
helped. So
no, always he was
thinking,
absorbed in her.
Too much attachment for this.
That always praising her, flattering. You are so beautiful. You are so qualified. And thus he wanted to be with her. Yes. So after this life, he became woman. And after some time, he was married to anyone other. But he has the association of Narad. So some devotion, the seed of devotion was
planted
in her. So he was married, she was again married to any beautiful, young and devotee king.
Malayadhaj.
And with him she was associating also, and after that he received some bhakti. And then he left this body and became devotees. So Narada is telling that if you want to be happy forever, then don't be engaged in all these worldly things. Give up at once. Anyone has not been satisfied in lakhs and lakhs births with husband and wife and in all jonis.
Species.
Never satisfied. Like ghee and
fire.
By giving fire, that ghee, it will go up. So anyone cannot satisfy. So you should not try to do all these things. Always chanting and remembering. Otherwise you will have to test all these things as Puranjan. So be very careful. You should not think that I'm young, a beautiful girl and beautiful young boy. So I must marry and after that I will test and then give up. It is absurd. Lakhs and lakhs verse. You have tested all these things. So from beginning, we should be have some vairagya. Vairagya means?
Detachment.
Detachment, all these things. You cannot be happy by these things. And sometimes something, I am thinking that many of you are realizing, divorcing one time, two time, three time, four time, five time. Even some, it may be in green,
Guinness book.
More than 50
times
they have changed, but none are happy. You cannot be happy. So he is telling that we should be very strong in these things. Don't waste your time. What about women, women girls? And if that any young boy can be brahmachari, why then cannot be young, very strong brahmachari? They must be. By soul we are same. By covering we are ladies, woman or male. Only this difference for only by
cloth.
As by changing sari, if you will take dhoti, kurta and all other things, and then you will become like men, and they will, if they are having so much long hairs and wearing like women, and then they will be seen like women. But really we are eternal servant of Krishna. So we should try to be happy forever by surrendering ourselves in the lotus feet of Gurudev. Very strong in these things. You cannot satisfy your these things. Appetite for
worldly
senses. Never, never. So don't waste your time. This verse should be given only in chanting, remembering of Krishna. After that, Parikshit Maharaj was so, मैं इसके द्वारा बहुत प्रभावित हुआ हूँ.
Influenced by this.
I know that I want to know how we should proceed in this. Then he told about Bharat Charitra. What is Bharat Charitra? You can. Can you do? Explain. Come on. Very brief, but very powerfully. You should take lesson. Right here in golden types, eternally, all these things. If I am success to write on your hearts all these things, my preaching is successful. I am not telling that you should give up. If you are married, no harm. From there you should chant, remember. And those who are renounced, they should be renounced very strongly. Very strongly. There is nothing in marriage. Only this is Dilli ka laddu. Dilli ka laddu, you know?
Air switch.
What? Dilli ka laddu? Jo khaya wo bhi pachtaya, jo nahi khaya wo bhi pachtaya. What?
This is a sort of laddu,
sweet laddu.
Who ate it, who did not eat it, he is repenting that I have not eaten it. And who ate it, he also repents, why I ate it.
Oh, there is a sweet like. It is like this, but very, it will come, if you will give in mouth, it will be gal jayegi.
Melt.
Will melt and come, like nothing, bitter taste. Hawaii.
What did he say? Hawaii?
Hawaii means
air.
Made of air.
Yeah, after
California,
shall go Hawaii.
Very airy place.
If Maharaj Yudhishthira went to hell, all the souls suffering there, they become so happy. Oh Prabhu, you should not go from here. Your smell is giving us so much
relief.
Relief. So no harm. Go on, go on.
So Bharat Maharaj was the son of Rishabhdev.
I have no time to explain all these things. There are so many deep things in all these things. If I am going to tell, then I will be engaged only in one upakhyan this 15 days, in one. But I want that you should listen something.
So Rishabhdev was a Shakti Veshavatar, a person empowered with a specific potency of the Lord. And he was a king. He had 100 sons. And of these 100 sons, 91 were like Kshatriyas. They were also princes or kings. And the other 9, they were Brahmins. The, what are they?
Navayogendras.
And the oldest of all the sons was Bharat.
91.
And towards the end of his life, Lord Rishabhdev, he gathered all his sons and he instructed them that Bharat was actually a very elevated soul and that they should follow him. So after this, Rishabhdev, he went to the forest and he gave up the kingdom and he was living as an avadut. Avadut means one who throws off all rules and regulations. So after this, Bharat Maharaj, he became king, and he was a very powerful king, and he ruled for several years. And then while he was still a young man, he also gave up the kingdom, and he went to the forest in order to perform austerities and in order to develop his love for Krishna. So it is said that he gave up the kingdom very easily, although as conditioned souls in this world, we are very attached to material enjoyments. And Bharat Maharaj, he had great facility for enjoyment. Being a king, he had wealth, and his wife was young and beautiful. So much facility he had for material enjoyment. But he gave it up all very easily because of his awakening of spiritual taste and his awakening of love for the Lord. So he went to the forest, and there he was engaged in deep meditation and worship of the Lord. And it is said that he attained to the stage of bhav, to the stage of rati. And at that stage, Swarup Shakti is awakened in the hearts, and one awakens deep attraction for the Lord. So he was at a very elevated stage of spiritual advancement. But one day, he saw that there was a deer who was running from a lion or a tiger and came to the bank of a river and was being pursued. And out of great fear, the deer jumped across the river. And as it, the deer was also pregnant with a baby deer. And when it jumped across, the baby deer was released from the womb, and the mother deer went across to the other side, it gave up its life. So Bharat saw all of this, and he became compassionate for the small deer. So he went and rescued the deer from the water, and then began to take care of it, and nourish it, and look after it. And gradually his attachment for the deer increased.
And
as a result,
same time. Go on.
Okay. As a result, his spiritual practices and meditation began to dwindle.
Yeah.
So his attachment grew more and more for the deer, and then one day the deer disappeared from the ashram, and he became greatly distressed. He was looking everywhere, but he could not find the deer, and he was lamenting so much. And then the end of his life approached, and just before he left his body, the deer again came. And he saw the deer, and because he was so absorbed in meditating on the deer, when he left his body, he took the form of a deer. Although because
what
of his...
deer came? Hmm? I could not understand. Deer came?
At the end of his life.
How he came? Never he returned.
No.
Only later he absorbed in deer.
He was only remembering, yeah. Oh,
deer,
where you have come, where he is gone. Never returned.
Yeah. Okay.
So, remembering and remembering, he died. So when he died, he was remembering, so he became deer in his next life. Go on.
Just as Krishna explains in the Bhagavad Gita, that whatever one meditates on at the time of death, then one will attain to that form. So he attained the form of a deer, but because of his spiritual advancement, he was able to remember his previous life. And so when he took the body of a deer, he was lamenting greatly that why did I become attached to this deer, and I don't want to make the same mistake again. So even though taking birth in the body of a deer, he left his mother and father deer, and he went to the same place where he was performing austerities, and there in the body of a deer, he engaged himself internally in remembering the Lord.
And also having association of the rishis there, because it was situated on the bank of Ganges and Gandaki. So many rishis were there, always
discussing
Harikatha, Srimad Bhagavatam, Puran, and all others. The whole day he used to hear, and in morning and evening he used to go to Ganges and take something. And in last, he took Ganges water and he took bath and he left his body. Then he became
Jarbara.
In Brahman, he came as a son of a Brahman boy.
So the word jar means inert or matter, and he was not.
Why he became Brahman? In the last time, when he was dying, he only thinking, oh, I should be renounced from this world. I will know Brahma, who is Brahma. And thus thinking this, he have a
chance
to be a Brahmin boy, and he had chance to develop his tattva jnana. So he, Krishna managed him. Go on.
So his father was a very qualified Brahmin, and he was very eager to teach his son all the Brahminical duties. But Bharat was thinking that previously I became entangled in material existence due to attachment for a deer. So he did not want to make the same mistake again. And he was thinking that if he followed carefully the instructions of his father, that so much material facility would come. He would receive respect in society. His parents eventually would want to get him married. So in this way, he would again become entangled in material existence. So therefore, although he was a highly realized soul, externally he behaved like a very dull person.
And like mad.
Therefore he was called
sometimes
Jara.
Naked, sometimes here, there. That brothers' wives used to give him
sister-in-law, which they supply.
Not good thing, but even he was so healthy, and he was happy.
So, because he behaved just like a dull-headed person, very foolish, he was abused and criticized by his brothers and his brothers' wives. But he did not care for this. He was always self-satisfied within. And especially after his father passed away, then his brothers and other family members, they took advantage of him. And they had him doing very hard labor in the fields and just feeding him very like coarse grains. But he never complained in any way. So one day, a band of dacoits came. And
They were looking for some person, for some like animalistic type man to offer in sacrifice. They were worshippers of the goddess Kali. And the person who they had selected for this had escaped from them. So then they came upon this Jagrabharat, and they saw that, oh, he is suitable person for this, because he is just like an animal. He's just very dull-witted. So he's a suitable person to offer in sacrifice. So although he was very strong and powerful, and he could have resisted, but he was just seeing this as the mercy of the Lord. He was seeing that whatever the Lord desires, I will accept. So he did not resist in any way. And they took him off and took him to
but
the place.
But always remembering Krishna, always. Anyone could not understand that always he is in like trance.
So then they took him before the deity of the goddess Kali, and they tied him up, and they were just about to kill him, and at that moment the goddess burst out of the deity form, and she had many arms and very ferocious looking, with fangs and so many, a garland of skulls and different weapons in her hands. And she immediately decapitated all the dacoits and saved Bharat Maharaj, or Jarabharat. So after this, he was wandering in the country.
When all were given in fire, all the dacoits, Kali began to tell, request him, oh, you accept me? You don't be in this way, otherwise worldly people will not know you. So please, any offense I have done or done by my persons, please excuse. I know that you are more powerful than me, but you are playing like a drama. I know. Always Krishna serving, saving you. So be merciful to me. Inspire some mercy that I can do bhajan to Krishna. So the devotees are so high, who are chanting, remembering Krishna, even more than all demigods. Then one day he was sitting in the night, anywhere in field, and what became? Rahugan came.
So he was. There was a king, Rahugana, who was traveling throughout his kingdom, and he was carried by the palanquin carriers, and one of the palanquin carriers became ill, so they had to find someone to replace him. So they came upon this Jarabharat, and they saw that he was very stout and strong, so they thought he is a good person to do this job. So they engaged him, but Jarabharat, being a great devotee and not wanting to commit any type of violence towards any living entities, as he was walking, he was looking down on the ground to see if there were any ants there. And so he was walking out of sync with the other palanquin carriers, which made the ride unbalanced and very upsetting to the king. So then the king began to chastise all the palanquin carriers, and they were putting the blame on this Jarabharat. They were saying, it's not our fault, but he's not walking properly. So then the king began to chastise him.
Began to first joke. Mm-hmm. Oh, you are very weak person. You cannot
carry
so much load.
Oh,
you are carrying alone. And even he was not speaking anything. Then he became angry. Oh, you are not thinking that I am king? I will punish you. Always remind this. And what he told more?
So, after insulting him in various ways, they went on walking again, but the same scenario happened again. So then the king became angry and began to chastise Jat Bharat and wanted to punish him.
You are very fat, you are very strong, still you are going, this nonsense, I will punish at once you. I am king of this whole world. Then Jat Bharat smiled and very honorably he told something. What he told?
I don't remember all the
You
details.
Don't remember? You should know. He told, you remember? Huh? Then you should stand. But don't do so. One, 2 hours.
Don't do so long. Only 1 hour.
Very quickly.
So, when Bharat Maharaj did again same thing, then king became angry and told.
To hoye geche pore porlen. Ekta explain kor.
You don't know I am emperor of this world, I am ruler of this world, I can punish you. Then Bharat Maharaj, then Jad Bharat mercifully told, Rahu ganaitat tapasa.
Not now. It is in the last.
I am not.
Thank you, thank you.
I'm not fair.
He told.
I'm not fair. Yeah.
That if there is body, then it is for carrying loads. You know? But who is king? And who is emperor? And who is subjects, mani praja?
Subjects.
You told me that you are very lean and thin first, and then you told me so fat. Who is lean? Who is fat? Who is carrying loads? If there is loads, then it should be carried. But what is that load? And he stopped to tell anything. Oh, king, I was going to Maharaj Kapil Dev. Oh, who is this person? And he jumped up from his palanquin and begged, and he did pranam to the Lord's feet of that Bharat. Who are you? And why you are doing so? But I think I could not understand. I'm going in association of Kapil Dev and all races, but I could not understand. Oh, I'm same Bharat. So many hundred years passed, I was Bharat. And my sons.
You came in my dynasty.
In my dynasty after so long time. I'm saying, you are Bharat? I've heard about Bharat so much things. And again he began to dandavat. I could not understand your all words. He told that you should try. Atma, I am Atma, soul. Eternal servant of Krishna. But I have forgotten him. And that is now I have come in this shape, covered by this material body and sukshma body, body of mind.
Subtle body.
Subtle body. And now I am thinking I am fat. You are thinking that you are emperor. For how many days you are emperor? Who is emperor? This body is emperor or this soul is this body is thin, you are thin, or this matter is thin? Who is fat? I know that there is only one load. What load? Load of this body. thinking all these worldly things. This is only Lord. The Lord of Palankpit is not Lord. So we are soul. You should understand. Anyone is not fat. Atma is what? Partitional. So there should be no any worldly false ego in this. Try to realize Atma. He told that if Atma has no relation with worldly suffering, sorrows and everything, and he is quite separate from this body and mind, then why he is suffering so much? He told that if you take in a vessel water, keep it in fire. He is telling king that take a vessel, in that vessel water some, and keep it on the
fire.
By fire the first the hot the water. Pot will be
hot.
Become hot. And by this water. In touch water will be
boiled.
And give some rice there, that they will be boiled. No? No direct touch. Fire to
rice.
Rice.
No direct connection.
So if there is Atma here, covered with this body, the suffering of this body will affect that Atma. So, but you are telling that no suffering, no death, nothing is there. How I'll realize all these things? Then he told that raho gane tat tapasan jati na chejya nirva panad grihatva na chandasa naiva jalagni surjo mahatpado rajo bhishekam. Oh, you cannot know all these things only by serving the feet dished of realized souls, devotees, so kind of qualified devotees. Only you will take bath by the lotus dust of that kinds of Mahatma, sadhu or devotee. Then you can realize. You cannot realize this by tapasa. Tapasa mane?
By austerities.
Austerities. Nacha ijya.
Worship.
Worship. What worship? Ganesh, Durga, Shankar, all. Not here is told that Krishna worship. Nirvam Padad by Vairagya. You cannot realize. By Grihatva. Grihat means being Grihastha and always doing fire sacrifice. Swaha, Swaha. It will not do. Nachandasa, only reading Vedas. Om Sahasra Shirsha Purushaha, like this. Likes and likes verse. By Sham, Rig, Jadu, Atharva, Ved, not reading by this. Jala, if you are worship water, like we going to Prayag or here, that these are teeth, but not serving devotees like that. Devotees are more powerful than Ganges, water. But that devotee should be devotee, not having any dvesh.
And malice.
Enviousness.
Animality or envious or anything. He should truly be. He knows how to serve Vaishnavas, having prem to Krishna. And to reject the persons who are bimukta to Krishna. Always chanting and remembering is doubt in Krishna. He has mercy for all. No? Also, Surjayi, someone, oh, give him water to sun, thinking him God. Om Bhur Bhuvasva Tat Savitur Varanyam, some thinks that this is the mantra of sun doing. No, it will affect. You cannot realize God, Krishna, Supreme Personality of Godhead, and you cannot realize by this thing Atma also. Bina mahat padar jobhishekam. Like Narad quickly taking one remnant of Mahaprasadam and hearing Harikatha, he became liberated. Ajamil taking only one name and he was revealed his everything. So, only Mahatpajor Vajyabhiresham. Only by the help, by the serving of the lotus dust of such kinds of devotees, anyone can easily realize all these things, otherwise never in whole life. So we should try to serve devotees like this. A guru never tells that bona fide that don't go and listen to Sukadeva Goswami. They cannot tell. And if they are telling, then they are not devotees. Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Shastre Kaya. Lo Matra Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Siddhiya. He is telling something. Wherever there is bona fide Harikatha is going on, try to listen it. Sukadeva Goswami has not a single disciple. Who were they who assembled there? All were liberated. Who were they? So we should try to go to devotees, serve them, and associate them. There is no
wall
of anything, caste, creed, or anything. Jai Krishna Bhaje.
Jai Krishna Tattavitta Sei Guru Hai.
Kiva Vipra, Kiva Nyashi Kei.
Sudra Kane Na.
Sudra Kane Na. He is Guru who is knowing all these things. So, we should try to follow like Bharat Maharaj. We want to follow only for Vairagya, not for his line. We want to go follow the line of Rupa Goswami. But his Vairagya is there. Tattva Gyan is there. So we want to learn his Vairagya and his practices. Even he was so high, he was qualified to be Rati there in his heart. But he was attached to worldly things like a deer and he came down for 3 verses. So don't try to be like that. Always remembering Bharat. But quickly, by the association of bhakts, he quickly again had same rati, and then rati to shuddha pure bhakti, and then prema bhakti, and he was liberated. Today, only this, up to this, again, anything to...
Name of Guru Varg.
চিন্তা করেছ
চিঠি লিখতে গঙ্গা সখী দিয়ে
গোদাবরী দিয়ে
হ্যাঁ
গৌরব হ্যাঁ হোয়াট ইজ নেম
গৌরব গুরুবাণী
হোয়ার ইজ গুরুবাণী স্ট্যান্ড আপ
গৌরপ্রিয়া
হ্যাঁ সি ইজ গিভেন নিউ নেম
গৌরপ্রিয়া
গৌরপ্রিয়া Beloved of Gaur Chandra, it may be like Vishnu Priya. So you are lucky to have this name. Gaur Priya ki?
Yes.
What's your name? Your daughters?
Daughters can stand up.
Huh. What name? Stand up.
Radha Priya.
Oh, Radha Priya is good name. So, Radha Priya ki?
Yes.
What name?
Revati.
Revati. Revati is also so good name. So Revati Devi ki.
Yes.
Kirtan? Oh, you should do. And you should.
Hare Krishna. One pair of cattails was lost during Harinam Sankirtan. They belong to Dear Krishna Prabhu. They have also initials in them. What are you?
DK.
DK.
good tune,
clear pronunciation,
8 strokes, 9.
Yeah.
And
to you, especially.